safety at sea is very important. And by adding a radar to the Simrad NSX, it now allows you to see land masses, track targets at sea, watch storm fronts. So this will give you that extra peace of mind while you're on the water. So we're gonna walk you through how to set it up and how to view and manage that data. Now, once we've got the radar installed, we've gone through the setup process. We now come to the radar screen and we have the ability quickly to stand by our transmit. So we will transmit the radar, start it going. You'll also notice the button next to it where it says halo. If I were to have multiple radars, or if I were to have a radar that would have dual range capabilities, I would hit the word halo and it would tell me what my sources are that I could select. So I could select on a true halo radar, halo A or halo B, because I've got two independent views there in a single radar. So now I can select which radar I want to view at that time. We can go through and we notice again, remember, anytime we get a tile, we can always expand to a full page. That icon's always there. You've got your zoom in and out. You also have the, just like a chart, you can move around and hit your home button, puts you right back on. But you can go and look at any target by putting a cursor on it. It'll give you a range and bearing. So quick and easy to find out. Distance, direction from your vessel, where a target is at any time. Simply hit the X to make it go away. Now we go into our menu. Now this is the menu just for the radar. Again, you'll notice it's a single page. But you also notice that we've got a lot more information about what these features are that you might want to change. So when we start, we go into modes. With our halo range, we have different modes. So custom is more of a manual mode, allows you to customize it. Harbor is when you're in tight quarters, very calm seas. Like going into a harbor and entranceway, we have a lot of traffic. You want to see things, it gets pretty aggressive. Offshore is again to take out, it filters out those erroneous wave errors from wave heights. And then bird, when you're talking about an open array, is when we're trying to find birds or small targets. When we're talking about a dome, it still has bird mode, but you're not going to see birds, but kind of use it as small target mode, where you'll see smaller targets at a further distance. When we go in, we can go in now, when we're in our custom mode, we can go and change our gain settings to manually manipulate that. Same thing with C. So sea clutter is when we're offshore, we have those waves coming in, they're gonna show erroneous error or erroneous targets on the screen. So we can increase our sea clutter to adjust that. And then we have rain. Rain is always left off unless we're in fog or rain. What happens is you're gonna see this speckle all over the screen, you wanna clear that up. But again, you don't wanna take it too high, because if you take it too high, you're actually gonna end up removing targets. So just clean it up to where you can see all the targets without that speckle all around. Now as we keep moving down, we have velocity track. So velocity track is our Doppler capability. So when we're in a palette, like a red palette here that's showing some land mass, if we were having moving targets and they were coming towards us, they would be in a yellow color. If they're moving away, they'd be in a blue. This is great for situational awareness, where we need to find out, is that target dangerous to us or not? By turning velocity track on, it makes those targets bright yellow in this palette. In a yellow palette, they'll be red. So it's an offsetting color that shows that the target's coming towards you, and anything leaving or diverging is always in blue. But you have the ability to just turn on just those approaching targets if you want. So I don't care about what's leaving because it's safe. I can either select normal with both incoming and outgoing, or approaching only. Next one down is our color palette. So we do have different palettes that we can go through and select. Again, this is all personal preference. If you like that white background, can show some of those smaller targets up a little bit better. When you start working with nighttime stuff, you've got green or yellow. So we have the ability to pick that. And again, it's all personal preference. And that's your color palette. Orientation, just like our chart, we could do heads up, north up, course up. So by simply just picking the appropriate, you'll notice that the chart will move around accordingly. Obviously, with course up and stuff like that, we need to make sure we do have a heading sensor in the on the vessel. Position, we have the ability, just like with our chart, where maybe we want to do a look ahead. So that puts it in that last one quarter. We're seeing more information ahead of the vessel. We can go back to center, or we have another feature called offset, where you're able to kind of put that and move that target So if I always want to see more to that starboard side every time I turn that back on, that's where it's going to stay. So you can, that's called offset. You can put it in a custom position, not just look ahead or center. So Symbology, if we go in here, this is where all of the information that's on the radar. So we can go and turn compass rings off if we don't care about them, you know, range rings. So we can go in and turn that stuff on and off, or completely turn everything on or off. Just go to a simplified screen. Again, it's up to your personal preference. So we start moving past Symbology. We have trail duration. Why would we need trail duration? So trail means when I'm tracking a target, how long do I want to leave that target information on the screen? So when I increase that and bring it up, you're going to start seeing some offsetting colors in blue. So as that target moves, that's going to stay on the screen for 30 seconds before it disappears. And you notice as it goes further and further in time, we actually change our colors. This is really helpful if you are looking for birds, because birds are going to show up as a small target. You don't catch them every sweep, but by turning on trails, you're able to look for an area on the radar that is about the size of a dime over a quarter that has all these multicolored targets. Because when you get erroneous wave heights, it'll be here, then it'll be over there, then it'll be over there. But when we're watching birds, you're going to get a target there, a target there, a target there, a target there. So it's always in the same area. But if we don't leave trails on, once it's ranged and disappears, it's gone.